Anyway, Bobby, I have a question for you. What does the Bible say about the end times? Are those left behind books accurate? Does anybody really know?
Well, you know, this is another one of those questions, just like Sean said with the last one, is more of an in-house debate. This is a question that believers can disagree on and still get along. They can go to the same church. They can be good friends because it's one of those issues that though it matters greatly, there's a lot of wiggle room in there. It's something that we would say is something that we hold with the open hand. I mean, there are things that we hold with a closed hand, like we hold the deity of Christ, that Jesus Christ is uniquely God, that God is a Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, that the Bible is God's Word. I mean, those are things we hold with a closed hand and we will not let go of. Some of the things we hold with the open hand is, you know, whether the tribulation, you know, is going to be, you know, if believers are going to live through all 7 years, or will there even be 7 years, or will they leave after 3.5 years? Or, I mean, there's all of that pre, mid, post tribulation debate. And of course, you know, with the popularity of the Left Behind series a few years back, it just, you know, brought it all up again. And, you know, I don't know how accurate those books are. No one does, because they're written about a future. You know, they're written about something that hadn't happened yet. I read probably halfway through the series and just got bored because I felt like they were taking longer than the actual tribulation. And so I just said, I can't do it anymore. You know, if I live through it, you know, that's cool. If I don't live through it, I'll watch it from heaven. And so, you know, that last question is really a great question. Does anybody really know? You know, Jesus said that no one knows. And no one knows the day or the hour when he's going to return. Now, we know and we hold with a closed hand that he's coming back because he promised. Okay? But whether it's premillennial, postmillennial, amillennial, all that kind of stuff, that's open for debate. Well, we're premillennial as a church. We're pre-trib as a church. But I always joke with people and tell them that I'm really just promillennial. I'm all for that millennial kingdom. I mean, I give it the thumbs up. And I'm anti-trib. No trib for me. Okay? No tribulation. Just give me the millennial kingdom. But, you know, it says in 2 Timothy that there's going to be a special reward for believers who love or long for his appearing. Not a special reward for people who believe the right thing about his appearing. You know, it's not going to be like we get to heaven and all the premillennialists are going to be high-fiving each other. All right, we knew. You know, or the people who are, you know, post-trib on the rapture are like, I knew it, we were right. You know, and everybody else has to go to a seminar or something. It's not going to be that way, okay? You know, it really comes down to right now, do I long for the appearing of Christ? Now, if he came right now, would I be happy? Or would I shrink away? You know, because there is a special reward, a crown for those who long for his appearing. So,